Welcome to JB's Cajun Kitchen. One fan wrote in and said, who does all these dishes? JB does them, that's who. Look at that, I poured the soap, I closed it, and there's dishes in here that I used last night. Go start the dishwasher. It ain't hard to do. Any man ought to know how to do that if he a real man. I got a tip. Here's an easy way to do your dishes. I ain't gonna show y'all. But you put them all on the floor. And then you get your spray out your zinc and spray down the floor and the dishes and everything. And then you just get a squeegee and just kind of, you clean the floor and the dishes at the same time. It's an easy way to do your dishes. All right, today, let's get serious. We're going to do us a Swedish meatloaf dinner. And you can make Swedish meatballs if you want. But I ain't. I'm going to make a meatloaf. It's going to be easier to do. It's going to be Swedish flavored with a Swedish gravy. And we're going to have some egg and noodles. And I'm going to probably do a JB version of Swedish cauliflower. I'll have to make that up as I go though. We just fly by the seat of JB's butt and do that. Probably be like a dill cauliflower thing. So, let me get the ground meat thawed out because it's a frozen. We just bought it the other day and I forgot to leave a couple packs out. We vacuum sealed them. Damn it, boy. Double damn it, boy. JB. Bad, bad, bad. Slap you two just for the hell of it. Come on, JB. Go to town. All right, boy. I got a recipe for this. Look here, a picture of it. Move out the way. Swedish meatloaf supper. All right. So what we got here, here's some of our ingredients. Salt and pepper, allspice, mushrooms, and I got some trio brown gravy mix, and I'm sure glad my measuring cups are in liters and lighters and things, because that's how this thing is. It's also in French over here, and I don't do French too well. So I got my motor. And here's the motorboat, the traditional motorboat slip on it. It's a Braun. It also comes with a Birdie Time, Whirly Birdie. And it also comes with a little chopper thing. A little small one. And that's all we're going to need. Because all we're going to do is put the mushrooms in there. And about half that onion. And Whirly Bird it. Chip a super whopper chopper and put that in that meat for that meatloaf. Boy. Now the first thing we gonna do is sharpen our knife. This is Rada cutlery and this is Rada's sharpening thing. And it works real good because this is a carbon steel knife and it don't take many whacks. It was already pretty sharp. So the first thing we're going to do is take an onion and cut him up and get him kind of rough chopped so I can put him in the food processing device there. Get out the way. Get all this junk off of that thing. And see this up here? That's the root end. You won't get rid of that. You don't want to eat that. So just take it and throw it out. See, there's one on this side too. Just get rid of that. It's kind of the tough part of the onion. Just peel that thing, JB. You don't want that peeling in there, do you? Hell no, boy. We're just going to kind of give it a rough whack up. And I'm going to try not to cry in front of you fine people. So, in go Mr. Onion. Like that. Come on, get in there. Now, Bavarian food and Swiss food, they don't use no whole lot of garlic. Get on that. Some things do, some things don't. See, simple food process. We done. We're gonna take that and chunk it up in there. And we're gonna retrieve the cutting blade and try not to slice the whole thing off. Open up some mushrooms. Oh, look. Plug it in, JB, and hit a run. We're gonna drain the juice out of it. And we're gonna use that for something else. Now we're gonna put them shrooms in there. And I might even taste one. Tastes good to me. Use fresh if you got them. Aggravate the hell out of it. Look like pate to me. How about that? Come out of there! Damn it, boy. Make me stick my fingers up in there. I'm glad I pulled that blade out first. Y'all seen that? Ooh, boy, JB was smart that time, huh? I'd have lost some fingertips. Been over here with band-aids and everything on my fingers. Now all I got is mushrooms. Yum, too. Alright, I got some fresh flat-leaf Italian flat-leaf parsley. And it say to snip it. I say snip it in the bud. Put it in there. Calls for a quarter cup. I don't know. Look at this flying everywhere. That looked like about a quarter of a cup. Over there. Calls for some salt. Oh, that was 80-20 ground chuck while y'all wasn't looking. Salt. Some pepper. How much pepper? A quarter cup? A quarter teaspoon? Shit. That's too much. Throw the rest in the zinc. Calls for allspice? A nutmeg. We're going to go with allspice. About that much like you saw. Alright, I got some fresh flat-leaf Italian flat-leaf parsley. And it say to snip it. I say snip it in the bud. Put it in there. Calls for a quarter cup. I don't know. Look at this flying everywhere. That looked like about a quarter of a cup. Over there. Calls for some salt. Oh, that was 80-20 ground chuck while y'all wasn't looking. Salt. Some pepper. How much pepper? A quarter cup? A quarter teaspoon? Shit. That's too much. Throw the rest in the zinc. Calls for allspice? A nutmeg. We're going to go with allspice. About that much like you saw. Now, got to get some milk. And an egg. Let me get that.